Product handling is key to the success when we're talking about dynamic checkweighing. In normal production lines, we have a chain conveyor in between the filler and the checkweigher. Chain conveyor have normally very big rollers. That means we need special conditions and special equipment to take over the products from the chain conveyor into the checkweigher. For example, here we have a side grip conveyor which is avoiding the gap on product falling over when taking over. A second set of these side grip conveyors will be normally then placed at the outfeed, because the same situation as we have in the infeed with a chain conveyor we will find at the outfeed. An interesting part of side grip conveyors is that you must have some adjustment for different products. For example, you have big cans and you have smaller cans. So you may run the different product sizes on the same line. And then you want to adjust the side grip conveyors to the product dimensions of your product. With such a smooth product transition and product handling, we can generate reliable and repeatable weighing readings for your benefit and with the accuracy you aim for. There might be some cases where products are not coming with the required space. In those cases, we're going to use some of the timing screws. Timing screws do have the feature and the task to make the required space available, which we would need by, let's say, distancing and scrolling the screw. So that means they're coming here back to back and they're ending here with the distance needed for the weighing conveyor. Once we have been weighing products, we may detect that some products are out of tolerances. These products shall be rejected. In case of cans, and maybe especially when they are still open and not sealed, we have solutions with sorting gates. These sorting gates rejecting products gently by dividing products which are out of tolerance onto a second conveyor, and so they're getting rejected upright standing gently and will be accumulated on a second conveyor with a dead end. When you're filling milk powder in pouches like that, you would need a checkweigher with a different setup. We may have pouches which do not come with the required product distance. For those cases, we're using then two infeed conveyors. The first one is accelerating the product to the gap which we need in order to have one length of the weighing conveyor in between two products. As milk powder, for example, is filled in these pouches, the product is flexible inside, and we do not want to have that the product is bouncing. Therefore, we're using then knife edges to allow a smooth product transition and to make the gap in between two rollers smaller. Product handling, product transition is a very important part for precise weighing. Together with some other factors like the design of the conveyors, like the servo drives, you get all these conditions which you need for precise, reliable weighing. 80% of a good weighing result comes from product handling, the other 20% coming from the weigh cell. Our weigh cell is easily handling the conditions and the environment which you need for this precision weighing which you want to have to fill as close to the nominal weight and to avoid over and underfilling. Influences from product weighing comes partly from product handling and product transition. But beside that, an important factor is also the quality of the measuring instrument. And the quality of the measuring instrument can be looked into with the so-called uncertainty. In order to verify the uncertainty of a checkweigher, we could enter the spot check mode and trying with the spot check to see what is the repeatability of a product. In our case, we would be using 30 times the trigger of the weigh cell to verify a weight stone of 50 gram, and we're starting now the spot check, we're starting the machine, and after having done that, we're putting the weight on. Once the checkweigher is started, we plate the weight stone of 50 gram onto the weighing conveyor, and we're starting now to initiate 30 times the weight reading of that preset waystone of 50 grams. Finish the spot check at that position, we can see that the precision of the checkweigher and its uncertainty is 44.5 mg and that the average weight reading after 30 readings is 49.9783 gram. From my point of view, this is a very precise dynamic checkweigher.